Hi and welcome to Allied Mathematics 2 class.
Here we are going to learn about LPP, Simplex Method in Linear Programming Problem. Simplex method is used due to the graphical method is inefficient to solve when there is more than two variables. All the constraints must be expressed in linear form in this. The standard maximum form. Usually the simplex method is always a maximum time. Sometimes it will be minimized where we have to change the objective function to maximized. And all the variables x size will be greater than or equal to 0. That is, they are all non-negative variables. And all constraints involved will be less than or equal to. The constraints on the right side in the constraints are all non-negative. Now we see an example in simplex problem. For example, use simplex method to minimize z is equal to x2 minus 3x3 plus 2x5 subject to 3x2 minus x3 plus 2x5 less than or equal to 7 minus 2x2 plus 4x3 less than or equal to 12 and minus 4x2 plus 3x3 plus 2x5 less than or equal to 10 and x2, x3, x5 greater than or equal to 0. Here, the main objective function is minimize z is equal to. So the first thing is we have to change minimize z to maximize z. For that we change z to z star and the right hand side will be multiplied by minus 1 and all the subject to constraints will be changed by adding a slack variable s1, s2, s3 since all of them are inequality. So we are going to change the inequality to equality. Then the standard form of LPP will become as therefore maximize z star is equal to minus x2 plus 3x3 minus 2x5 plus 0s1 plus 0s2 plus 0s3 which is subject to 3x2 minus x3 plus 2x5 plus s1 plus 0s2 plus 0s3 equal to 7 minus 2x2 plus 4x3 plus 0x5 plus 0s1 plus s2 plus 0s3 equal to 12 and minus 4x2 plus 3x3 plus 2x5 plus 0s1 plus 0s2 plus s3 equal to 10. Because in the previous slide, it is given here what the changes we have made is we are adding s1, s2 and s3 for all the three inequalities. And similarly, for the objective function, you are making it as 0s1 and 0s2 and 0s3. So now the variables are x2, x3, x5, s1, s2, s3. So the basic solution will be n minus m, which is equal to 6 minus 3 equal to 3. That is, m denotes the number of variables x1, x2, x3, x5, s1, s2, s3. So 6 variables, and m is the number of equations. So it is 3 equations. So 6 minus 3 is 3. So we are having 3 basic variables and 3 non-basic variables. And the 3 non-basic variables are x2, x3 and x5, which is always greater than, which is equal to 0. So s1 becomes as, when these are all equal to 0, the equation becomes as 3x2 minus x3 plus 2x5 plus s1 is equal to 7. So s1 equal to 7 and s2 equal to 12 and s3 equal to 10. Now we do an initial iteration using the simplex method. So first we write the maximize z is equal to here as minus 1, 3, minus 2, 0, 0, cd, yb, xb. So this x2, x3, x5, s1, s2, s3, these are all denoting x2. Now both the x2 will be writing the maximize z is equal to all their variables of x2, x3, x5, s1, s2, s3. So that is your cj. The cj is representing maximize z is equal to what we have got it as minus x2 plus 3x3 minus 2x5 plus 0s1 plus 0s2 plus 0s3. That is what it is here. And cb and yb. Cb is your coefficient of the s1, s2, s3 variables. So we write yb as yb is always your now s1, s2, s3. These are the basic variables. The basic variables represented as yb. The coefficient of the basic variables is represented as cb, which is 0, 0, 0. And xb is the right-hand side function of the inequality. So less than equal to 7, less than equal to 12, less than equal to 10. So these are all written as xb. And x2 denotes from the equation, we are getting subject to constants 3x2 minus x3 plus 2x5. So we write it as 3 minus 1, 2 and plus s1 as 1 s1, 0 s2 plus 0 s3. And the next equation in the second row will be 12x, that is minus 2x2 plus 4x3 plus 0 x5 plus 0 s1 plus s2 plus 0 s3. And then here it will be, the third one will be minus 4x2 plus 3x3 plus 8x5 plus 0s1 plus 0s2 plus s3. And so that will be less than equal to 10 is written in your xb itself. So now we have written all these things. And we are going to find out zj minus cj. Zj star minus cj. Your zj star minus cj is the coefficient cb into the xb. Each and every term, we are multiplying cb into xb. Cb into xb in each row, cb into xb plus second row cb into xb plus the third row cb into xb. When you add it, it will be 0, 0, 0. So it is 0. For the next one, next two, under the x2 column, 0 into 3 plus 0 into minus 2, 0 into minus 4 is 0 minus minus 1, because the cj is on the top. The cj is minus 1 and here one of the negatives are. So 0 minus of minus 1 is plus 1. So when you go for the next column x3, 0 into minus 1, 0 into 4, 0 into 3, the 0 minus 3 on the top. So it is minus 3 alone. For the next x5, it is 0 of minus 2. So you get it as 2. And s1 is 0, s2 under s2, everything is 0, s3 is 0. Now, zj minus cj star, you are getting the 0, 1, minus 3 and 2. One of the variables here is less than 0. So, the current basic feasible solution is not an optimal solution. If it is greater than 0 only, the solution is optimal. Therefore, minus 3, we denote that minus in the negative element, we take it as a pivot corresponding column. So, we mark it as the pivot corresponding column minus 3. And then we go for to find the theta. Theta is your xb divided by this pivot column element. So 7 divided by minus 1, whenever you get a negative value, it is left out as dash. 7 by minus 1, we don't take it into consideration. Then 12 by 4, which is equal to 3. Then 10 by 3 is 3.3. So under this theta, we have to find out which is the minimum value. First one is dash and second one is 3, third one is 3.3. So the least of this minimum of theta is 3, that is your second row. So you mark the second row. So when the intersection of the corresponding the pivot column and the pivot row will give you the element 4, which is your pivot element. The s2, now this corresponding pivot column is your x3, corresponding pivot row is your s2. So s2 leaves and x3 enters. Because of this, only the s2 variable leaves the basis. The new pivot equation is the old pivot equation divided by the pivot element, because s1, that is your s2 leaves and x3 enters, that x3 is your new pivot equation. X3 is equal to take the that row elements 12 minus 2, 4, 0, 0, 1, 0. We divide by the pivot element. The pivot element is the intersecting of the row and the column, that is divided by 4. So we get the new pivot equation as 3 minus half 1, 0, 0, 1 by 4 and 0. With this, then we are going to find out, with the pivot equation only, we are going to find out the new S1 as well as new S3 and new ZJ minus CJ. New S1 will be, for this, the type of equation is old S1 equation minus the corresponding column coefficient of that row S1 into the new pivot equation. new S1 equal to 7, 3 minus 1, 2, 1, 0, 0. That the new old equation minus the new pivot equation into the corresponding column coefficient. This corresponding element here is minus 1 into the corresponding new pivot equation is minus 3, 1 by 2, minus 1, 0, 0, minus 4, 1 by 4 and 0. When you subtract it, you get it as 10, 5 by 2, 0, 2, 1 and 1 by 4 and 0. Next, the new S3 we have to find out. Similar type, the old equation minus the corresponding column coefficient into the new pivot equation. The old S3 is 10 minus 4, 3, 8, 0, 0 and 1 minus, here also the value is, the value of the element is 3 into minus 3, because you get it as 9. So when you multiply by 3 throughout, 3 is 9, so minus 3 and the minus 3 by 2 and then 3, then 0, 0 and 3 by 4, 0. So you are subtracting it. On subtracting, you will get it as 10 minus 9 is 1 and subtract minus 9 by 2, 0, 8, 0, minus 3 by 4 and 1. Now we write everything in the first iteration. So the CJ is minus 1. CJ never changes. That is a maxima Z. That is Z star is equal to minus 1, 3, minus 2, 0, 0. CB, YB, XB, X2, X3, X5, S1, S2, S3 and theta. Here ZB is your 0. And S1 is equal to S1. The new S1 only you have to replace it here. So 10, 5 by 2, 0, 2, 1, 1 by 4 and 0. And then S2 leaves, X3 enters. So instead of X3, the coefficient of X3 in the maximized Z is 3. So you have to write in the coefficient as 3, X3. And XB value is 3, minus 1 by 2, 1, 0, 0, 1 by 4 and 0. And now we find the value of S3. S3, we have already found the value of S3, which is your new S3, which is 1 minus 5 by 2, 0, 8, 0, minus 3 by 4 and 1. And also the new ZJ star minus CJ is 9 minus 1 by 2, 0, 2, 0, 3 by 4 and 0. Here also there is one negative element, which is ZJ star minus CJ is less than 0, which is minus 1 by 2. So the current basic solution, feasible solution is not optimal. So we choose this minus 1 by 2 element, that column as your pivot column. And we have to find out similarly theta, the minimum value of theta. Now if I take the theta is equal to XB divided by the pivot column elements. The corresponding pivot column is 10 divided by 5 by 2, which is equal to 4. And 3 divided by minus 1 by 2 is V2, because since it's a negative element, we leave it. And 1 divided by minus 5 by 2, that is also a negative one, we leave it. So we got only 4 is the only element. This 4, you mark it as that row, we are marking it fully. So the intersection of this will give you 5 by 2. The pivot row and the pivot column will give you 5 by 2. That is your pivot element. So X2 leaves and S1 enters. So X2 enters and S1 leaves the basis. So the new pivot number is 5 by 2. And the new pivot equation is 10, 5 by 2, 0, 2, 1, 1 by 4 and 0. Divide by the 5 by 2. We'll get it as 4, 1, 0, 4 by 5, 2 by 5, 1 by 10 and 0. This is your new pivot equation. Now we find the new X3 as well as the new S3. The new X3 is the old X3 minus the element here is minus 1 by 2 into minus 1 by 2 into the new pivot equation. So it is, so we'll give it as minus 4 by 2, minus 1 by 2, 0, minus 4 by 10, minus 2 by 10 and minus 1 by 20 and 0. When you subtract it, you'll get it as 5, 0, 1, 2 by 5, 1 by 5 and 6 by 20 and 0. Which is 6 by 20, we can minimize it. So it becomes as 3 by 10. The new X3, S3 will be equal to old S3. Minus the corresponding coefficient element in the S3 is minus 5 by 2 into that 4 1 0 4 5, 4 by 5, 2 by 5, and 1 by 10, which gives you -4 into 5 by 10, -5 by 2, and 0, -4 into 5 by 2, 2 by 5 into 5 by 2, -5 by 2, and 1 by 10 into -5 by 2, and 0, which will be giving on reducing this, subtracting, you will get it as 1 minus, it will give you as 11 0 0 10 1, -10 by 20, which is -half and 1. ZJ star minus CJ. The new ZJ star minus CJ star. CJ will be giving you 9. Old is ZJ star minus CJ, which is 9, minus half, 0, 2, 0, 3 by 4, and 0. Minus this element, coefficient element, the corresponding element is minus 1 by 2 into minus 1 by 2 into see the previous equation, the new pivot equation, which is 4, 1, 0, 4 by 5, 2 by 5 into 1 by 10 and 0. Multiply it and write it here. So we get it as minus 2, minus 1 by 2, 0, minus 2 by 5, minus 1 by 5, minus 1 by 20 and 0. Subtracting 9 minus of minus 2, 11, and next one is 0 and 0, and 12 by 5, 1 by 5, and 4 by 5 and 0. So ZJ star minus CJ will be greater than 0. Here all the ZJ star minus CJ, now it's greater than 0. Therefore, the current basic feasible solution is optimal. So we found out the optimal solution. How to find out the optimal solution? In the tabular column, write everything in the tabular column in second iteration. So the second iteration, we have to write it and see it. Here CJ minus 1, 3, minus 2, 0 and 0. CB, YB, XB, X2, X3, X5, S1, S2, S3. Under the CB, X2 is entering. So the value of X2 should be written as minus 1. And the XB value is 4. And the X1, X2 is now the changed X2. New X2 will be 4, 1, 0, 4 by 5, 2 by 5, 1 by 10 and 0. New X3, you have to write it. That is 5, 0, 1, 2 by 5, 1 by 5, 3 by 10 and 0. New S3 is 11, 0, 0, 10, 1, minus 1 by 2 and 1. Therefore, ZJ star minus CJ is 11, 0, 0. New ZJ star minus CJ. That will give you 11, 0, 0, 12 by 5, 1 by 5, 4 by 5 and 0. This tabular column, we can easily find out that ZJ star minus CJ is greater than 0. Therefore, ZJ star minus CJ is greater than 0. The current basic feasible solution is optimal. Maximum Z star is equal to 11 and X2 equal to 4. You from the tabular column, you can find it only. The value in the XB will give you XB. That gives you the Z value. Maximize of Z star is equal to 11 and X2 value equal to 4, X3 equal to 5 and X5 is 0. See that column in XB, that gives the value of this elements. So now we maximize of Z star is 11, but what is Z? Minimize of Z is equal to negative value only. So it is minus 11. We have changed it now. X2 equal to 4, X3 equal to 5 and X5 equal to 0. So the next few slides will be about how we have done the steps of all these problems. Of this problem, how algorithm of doing the step-by-step method of doing this. You can go through all these slides for the method of doing it. The next step is assignment. I am giving you assignment for you to practice. So use the simplest method to solve the LPP. Maximize Z is equal to 4x1 plus 10x2 subject to 2x1 plus x2 less than equal to 15. 2x1 plus 5x2 less than equal to 100, 2x1 plus 3x2 less than equal to 90, and x1 comma x2 is greater than equal to 0. So just remember that this is a maximized z equal to, there is no need to change this z. You can do the problem. It is a very simple problem. Try to finish it.